both mental and spiritual anguish. But this is the 80s, and religious music will never be the same again.
You know, it would be dead because
she didn't want to go.
Because I thought they'd sing "All Jesus" and they'd be real, you know, and boring and dead. But they're really good. I like their music and what they talk about.
Instead of quoting a specific lyric, I could spell one name for you, and it's J-E-S-U-S. That would kind of stand for all the lyrics.
The lyrics are different. They talk about morals and not, you know, drugs and stuff. And they really reach out.
I think if rock music today, which is a powerful influence, not only on young people but on all type of people, if it did not promote rape, violence, drug traffic, and murder, the world would be a lot better place.
The music is like his voice, and the guitar is like so heavy metal, but it's bad. They don't use no devil madness in it. It's great. We waited a long time for this kind of band. Long time we waited, and they're finally here.
The loud headbanging music, miles of hair, pounds of makeup, and spandex costumes are a means of spreading the word of God. Stryper has raised its banner high and has become America's preeminent heavy metal band, rocking for Jesus. Their name is derived from the book of Isaiah, chapter 53, verse 5. By his stripes we are healed. And to the members of the band, Stryper's look is a symbolic representation of Isaiah's prophecy. Stryper vocalist, Michael Sweet.
We all wear striped clothes, our guitars are striped, our amps are striped, and what it signifies is Christ was beaten before he was nailed to the cross with the cat of nine tails, and that's what the stripes signify. The name Stryper stands, each letter stands for something. It stands for salvation, through redemption, yielding peace, encouragement, and righteousness. We want to express Jesus in our music, in what we wear, the name, everything. We only want to give glory to Jesus.
Jesus Christ, the way, the truth, and the life. Can I hear a big growl on that one?
If the music and the message seem like strange bedfellows, well, imagine the reaction of a startled record executive the first time he understood the group's lyrics. Enigma Records president, Wes Hine.
We're all sitting around the studio in the mixing room, and the lyrics are just booming through, listening very loud, and all of a sudden we hear, "Jesus is the way." So I was there with somebody else, and we looked, and they said, are you Christians? And they said, yes. And immediately, my initial reaction was, oh no, I thought I had this perfect band, they're good-looking guys, everything's for them, they've got the image, they've got the look, they're great songwriters, they're Christians, oh no.
I've never told you that, it's spreading the news to the world! You've got to spin your lives over the ground, you've got to change from mom to life.
Stryper guitarist, Oz Fox.
It's the only way you're going to really reach people that are listening to that kind of music. That's, you know, most of the time it's usually violent or satanic or whatever. We are able to bring that kind of music with a Christian message to a lot of young kids that are, you know, getting caught up in the bad stuff.
Someone you can turn to, KYMS.
Good morning. Greg Fast with you until 10 o'clock this morning from KYMS. Someone you can turn to. This album is really hot. It's their latest from Stryper. The song is titled Together as One.
Contemporary Christian music is among one of the fastest growing areas of the music industry today, but a limited number of radio stations play evangelical pop. KYMS FM carries a Christian music format and is an outlet for Stryper's music. Station General Manager David Toberty.
Even though it has a few radio outlets where people could hear the music, it is on a par or surpassed jazz and classical and country. And so that says a lot. The quality of the music is just oh so good, and is being brought because there's a big need.
KYMS programming director Greg Fast.
You know, I am not a heavy metal fan by trade, and so when I heard about these guys and their pants and long hair and what they were coming off with, I thought, no way. And I was won over. I think our station was, and the honesty and the sincereness of the ministry as a whole.
Yeah, yeah!
While the band sings about the glory of God, they also spread the word by throwing up to 300 striper Bibles to their screaming concert fans. The greatest inconsistency in the band's image is the marriage of rock and violence appearing on their album jackets, making them look like the born-again version of Rambo, striper drummer Robert Sweet.
We're trying to make a point, and that is a good and evil at a constant fight with one another. And the Bible talks on how when you're a Christian, you've got to put on the full armor of God.
Music is a powerful medium for spreading a religious message, but Striper's brand of Christianity has received mixed notices among church officials. Some feel that rocking for God is the work of Satan, while others find their music a healthy alternative to mainstream rock and roll. Pastor Chuck Smith of the Calvary Chapel.
You take Prince singing his lyrics that sort of advocates incest. Madonna, who essentially says, use your body to get what you want. So I think that it is really a refreshing and really a very exciting thing to me that music can also be used to implant good values into the minds of the kids. And that's what I see Striper doing.
While Striper is changing the sound of Christian music, the message remains the same.